Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking.
Man, Japan, it's amazing, just like the culture and everything that I believe about the martial arts and the things that I follow, right? Just the morals and everything that I learned with jiu-jitsu, I believe that it came from here. So just coming back here and being able to present my work and just receive the love of the fans, it's amazing. So every chance I get, I try to come here as much as possible, and this is my second time now. And I hope to continue to do this every single year. There's just things that I believe that every jiu-jitsu practitioner should do, right? And I feel like there's a few different ones, like going to Brazil and competing there, or at least like understanding the environment. Coming to Japan and competing here is another one of them. And then just, you know, receiving the love of the people that truly love the sport and they're so passionate about it and they're so respectful. So coming to Japan, if you're really thinking about doing this, it's a must do. It's a must do. It's a must. You must put that on your list and you must check it. So last year when I came here, it was amazing. I had a great time. And I'm looking forward to tomorrow because I'm about to compete tomorrow as well. So I just love being here. Yeah.
Thank you.
Feel great. So I'm about to compete in a few hours. I'm already on weight, so I'm excited to go. And yes, it should be very fun and excited to be out there. No, my travel here was pretty easy. I got a straight flight from LAX all the way to Japan, so it was pretty easy. I also brought family over with me, so we had a great time. And yes, I'm just enjoying all my time, every single second that I'm living here in Japan. And yesterday I had the seminar, and yeah, just enjoying and then just staying composed and ready to go. I like to just stay calm, just rethinking about my training rituals and just be rethinking about my plan on going out there and what I'm planning on doing it, and then just take it match by match. So I don't try to plan so much. I feel like I just go one match at a time, and that way I try to enjoy the competition, right? If you try to go things too fast, you try to do things too fast and you just don't end up enjoying the full experience, you know? So I try to take a match at a time, and then I feel like that way I enjoy every second of the competition, and I end up embracing the environment. And that's what I look forward to do every time I'm in the competition scene.
Like tough opponent, like good, like won worlds in the blue and purple before. So we knew him, I think like Taina is just a different level, man. Like he's like make like guys that are really good, like look bad, but it is what it is. Like he's really good. Like he's in a mental state where like he's very hungry, like to win competitions and to show his work, and that's all we want, right? Like we want the person that is in the competition but wants to be there. That's the difference. And he wants to be there. He wants people to watch him. He wants to be like with the cameras on him, and like he's embracing that like really well. And when you have that, I think like you're able to alleviate a lot of the pressure, and it helps a lot the athlete to stay composed during the match. That's what we saw. Like he pulled guard, wait for the right moment, and went straight to the submission.
Mendes, Talfram, Ego Jerry.
I'm a very faithful person, so I listen a lot to worship songs. I mean, I know it's preference, right? It's like people do it differently, but I've seemed to find my peace when I do that. I used to listen to a lot of like, you know, energetic music and try to get me like to pump it up and stuff like that. But I find I'm at my best when I'm calm. You know, I'm very aware, I'm very alert, and I'm very precise when I'm calm. So like that's what the worship song does for me. It keeps me calm, keeps me cool and sharp, you know. So I just listen to that to calm me down, and I make sure I keep my mindset sharp for the fight, you know. So.
I think he's Satoshi's brother, like little brother. So it was awesome because Satoshi is the person that I'm watching coming up. As it was a color belt, he was winning the black belt division. So it's a person I look up to. And just, I know that he's doing a phenomenal job here in Japan. And he's like very well known. So I respect him and his team a lot. And it was a blessing sharing the match with his brother. I started moving, started feeling him out. Felt very comfortable at the top position, and then just began to work my transitions from there. Then once I got to a dominant position, I knew that I had done enough to continue build from the dominant position into it leads to the submission. So that's what I did. Start isolating the arms, climb up to the high mount, and I just finished with a basic armbar, which to me, like just this simple jiu-jitsu is what brightens up my eyes, you know. So I love doing that, and I got one more. I hope I get to do that again. It was good. A lot of movements, tough opponent. It was good. I always say this, I try to train every day, not really thinking about a specific competition, but just thinking about like being creative, being unique, presenting something unique. I feel like whenever I watch jiu-jitsu, I could care less about who wins and who loses. Of course, every time you sign up for a competition, you're always aiming for the first place. But I look at myself trying to set the bar higher. I feel like that's kind of like my job to do. Based on how much I train, how much I dedicate myself, how much I work hard, and so it would be a waste of time if I wouldn't be preparing this way, you know, if I wouldn't be thinking jiu-jitsu this differently. So I feel like every time I'm training like that, more creative, trying to open up my vision. And of course, training where I'm training, I couldn't, you know, there's no way I'm not gonna be able to do that. Like Professor Hafi, Professor Gi, they're the ones behind all this, you know, so they deserve all the credit. Everything that I do comes from them, so there wouldn't be any Thailand Dalpur if there were the Mendes brothers. So, you know, so those are the men for me. So, like, that's the people that I look up to, and you know, I'm trying, preparing to set the bar even higher and continue to build my legacy. I think just competition is important, winning is important, but with jiu-jitsu, you learn so much more than just that. Just your morals, your character, personality, and just try to go deep about martial art. You know, it's not just jiu-jitsu and coming here winning and scrapping. There's a lot more to learn, you know, so why hold yourself back when you can open up the book and learn so much from it, you know? So if you're out there and you're listening to this, and maybe you're this upcoming star, or you know, you're starting, initiating your jiu-jitsu career, look to for the people that have done it in the past and the ones that truly succeed in the sport. You know, success is not winning. I feel success is being able to impact lives. You know, that's kind of like my mission right now. Like, for a long time, I had this mentality of just winning competition, and I felt it was just so selfish and arrogant. And whenever I opened up my mind to impact lives and change for a better, that's when good fruits start coming my way. You know, that's when I start to really harvest the fruit of my hard work. And you know, it's amazing when you think this way, there's no pressure. You're just really trying to challenge yourself every single day and set the bar higher. That's what it's all about, you know? So yeah, jiu-jitsu is all about expressing yourself and being respectful and humble, and just put it all together, you know? You're gonna see a lot of different people doing it differently. That's up to them. You know, I choose to do it this way. That's the way how my parents educated me. That's the way how I grew up with the Mendes brothers. And I always gotta see myself as an example for the next generation. So I work with a group of kids. I teach the kids class back home. And to me, more important than winning gold today is set the example for them. You know, make sure that they see it, all of this. They see not just winning, but everything that comes with it. You know, everything that you need to do during the process to achieve it. And when you do achieve it, look at things that you can get better at, you know. So the competition is today, tomorrow is just another day, you know. So we continue, we carry on, and we try to do better each time and just impact lives overall. Thank you, IBJJF. I appreciate the platform that you guys have been building, not just for me, but for my students, for the next generation coming after me. You guys are truly professional with the sport, and again, if you have the right mentality, you build your name in here, and you're able to harvest the fruit of your hard work with some smart work, you know. So yeah, that's when I come here. I love the atmosphere, the environment, and just the love of the people that appreciate my work. So it's amazing. If you have ever a chance to come to Japan, again, it's a must do. You must come here and embrace this, you know. It's amazing, and I'm very grateful. I'm very blessed to be in this position and to be able to embrace and absorb this whole experience, you know. So right now I got a week of vacation with my family. My mom and my dad are here, my wife is here, and I'm gonna have a couple seminars as well. So thank you, Japan, for always the warm welcoming, and I hope to come back each year and do it better every time.